Ja, dan moet ik wachten. Ja, hallo.
Ja, Micha hier met een hele slechte telefoon. De verbinding kan elk moment worden verbroken. Vrijdag mijn trial. Live or die. Ik wil met jullie nu wat bijbelteksten doornemen. Om te beginnen Jeremia 26. Heel belangrijk. In the beginning of the reign of Jehoiakim, the son of Josiah, king of Judah, this word came from the Lord. Thus says the Lord, stand in the court of the Lord's house and speak to all the cities of Judah that come to worship in the house of the Lord all the words that I command you to speak to them. Do not hold back a word. It may be they will listen and everyone turn from his evil way, that I may relent of the disaster that I intend to do to them because of their evil deeds. You shall say to them, thus says the Lord, if you will not listen to me, to walk in my law that I have set before you, and to listen to the words of my servants the prophets, whom I sent to you urgently, then I will make this house like Shiloh, that is hell, and I will make this city a curse for all the nations of the earth. The priest and the prophets and all the people heard Jeremiah speaking these words in the house of the Lord. And when Jeremiah had finished speaking all that the Lord had commanded him to speak to all the people, then the priest and the prophets and all the people let hold of him, saying, you shall die. Why have you prophesied in the name of the Lord, saying, this house shall be like hell, and this city shall be desolate without inhabitants? And all the people gathered around Jeremiah in the house of the Lord. When the officials of Judah heard those things, they came up from the king's house to the house of the Lord and took their seat in the entry of the new gate of the house of the Lord. Then the priest and the prophet said to the officials and all the people, this man deserves the sentence of death because he has prophesied against this city, as you have heard with your own ears. Then Jeremiah spoke to all the officials and all the people, saying, the Lord sent me to prophesy against this house and this city all the words that you have heard. Now therefore, mend your ways and your deeds, and obey the voice of the Lord your God, and the Lord will relent of the disaster that he has pronounced against you. But as for me, behold, I am in your hands. Do with me as seems good and right to you. Only know for certain that if you put me to death, you will bring innocent blood upon yourselves and upon this city and its inhabitants. For in truth, the Lord sent me to you to speak all these words in your ears. Okay, tot zover Jeremia. En dan wil ik graag ook nog voor jullie Psalm 91 laten horen. Die gaat als volgt. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. For he will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness is a shield and buckler. You will not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in darkness, nor the destruction that wastes at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only look with your eyes and see the recompense of the wicked. Because you have made the Lord your dwelling place, the Most High, who is my refuge, no evil shall be allowed to befall you, no plague come near your tents. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. On their hands they will bear you up, lest you strike your foot against a stone. You will tread on the lion and the adder, the young lion and the serpent you will trample underfoot. Because he holds fast to me in love, I will deliver him. I will protect him because he knows my name. When he calls to me, I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will rescue him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. Tot zover Psalm 91. Dan heb ik nog voor jullie een brief die ik wel voorlezen. December 2021, beste Micha. Bij deze een kaartje om je te laten weten dat we aan je denken. Sinds je in 2010 in het Frontier Magazine verscheen met het winnen van de Frontier Awards, zijn we je verslaggeving gaan volgen. De artikelen op Klokkenluider Online als mede de uitzendingen op de vrijdag op Argus Oog destijds. Dergelijke journalistiek zagen we vrijwel nergens. En je schreef over grote en schokkende zaken. Je hebt Nederlanders laten zien in wat voor land zij werkelijk leven en hoe de machtsverhoudingen liggen. Ik weet zeker dat veel slachtoffers je dankbaar zijn voor het onthullen van tal van zaken van de, want van de media kunnen we immers niks verwachten. En dan Joost zijn zaak, wat een verhaal. En wat goed dat je dat hebt opgepakt. De Red Bull Journal uitzendingen hebben we met veel interesse en verbazing gevolgd. De manier waarop jullie door de media zijn weggezet bevestigt alleen maar jullie gelijk. Evenals de onrechtmatige gang van zaken in jullie huidige processen. Jullie mogen dan in gijzeling zitten. De informatie die jullie dit jaar naar buiten hebben gebracht is zeer waardevol en zal zijn weg vinden als de tijd daar rijp voor is, dat weet ik zeker. Micha, enorm bedankt voor je journalistieke inzet. We blijven het volgen. Dat je altijd bent doorgegaan, ondanks hoge prijs die je ervoor hebt betaald. In de vorm van alle mogelijke tegenwerkingen is zeer bewonderenswaardig. Houd vol, houd moed. Je weet, er gebeuren grote dingen in de wereld ten goede van het licht. We worden ongetwijfeld bijgestaan door hogere krachten en we zullen hier uitkomen. Dat kan niet anders. Een brief uit Blaas.